Well, let's get right over to Ann Makovic at the live news desk with the latest on the Dixie Fire. Ann?
Again, this is a story that we've heard before, PG&E's equipment being linked to several major wildfires, including the one in Paradise that killed 85 people in 2018. And now PG&E admitting in a filing with the California Public Utilities Commission that its equipment may be to blame for the Dixie Fire that is burning in Northern California. More than 30,000 acres so far in Butte and Plumas County, 15% contained. It has been burning since July 13th. And in PG&E's filing, it says an employee responded to a power outage that day at the Cresta Dam and noticed a blown fuse, but couldn't get to it for almost 8 hours because the terrain was rough and there was some road work in the area. When he did, he found a tree leaning on a conductor and a fire nearby. Firefighters have been battling flames in the Feather River Canyon ever since. CAL FIRE has not named an official cause of the fire yet, but they have confiscated some of PG&E's equipment in their investigation. So in a statement today, a PG&E spokesperson said in part, the information PG&E submitted is preliminary, and the company submitted this report in an abundance of caution, given CAL FIRE's collection of PG&E facilities in connection with this investigation. It goes on to say PG&E is cooperating with CAL FIRE's investigation. Now, PG&E's stock price is down, no surprise, because the entire stock market is a mess right now. I know you're going to get to that in a minute, but this is all unfortunate for PG&E stockholders, people who are victims of PG&E's past fires right now own almost a quarter of the company's public shares. Lena Michelle.
All right, Ann, thank you. Firefighters are also busy with the Tamarack Fire in Alpine County. 23,000 acres have burned there since a lightning strike sparked it on the 4th of July. That fire forced the closure of a 26-mile stretch of Pacific Crest Trail and forced families out of their homes. Meteorologist Mary Lee joins us now with a look at the conditions crews are facing. Mary.
Yeah, Len, keeping a very close eye on weather conditions and what firefighters are up against for the Tamarack Fire as well as the Dixie Fire. So let's get right to it here. And this is the Tamarack Fire and what firefighters are dealing with. This is south of Lake Tahoe. Temperatures in the upper 60s to upper 70s. Humidity at 30% with the southwesterly winds gusting up to about 13 miles per hour. And the Dixie Fire, burning in Butte and Plumas County, is near Paradise. Temperatures there in the upper 70s to upper 80s, 17 to 26% relative humidity. So it's very dry, not just near the Paradise area, but also near the South Lake Tahoe area. Gusting up to about 17 miles per hour right now near Paradise, what firefighters are dealing with. And this is something I'm watching closely for you on high def Doppler. You can see all of those lightning strikes over Nevada as well as up over the Sierra. And a closer look, you can see all of those lightning strikes moving right over Mammoth Lakes there and approaching as it pushes north into the Tahoe area. Of course, we'll be watching this closely as we head through the rest of today with all of this activity to our east.